Welcome to Indie Parishad, a podcast dedicated entirely to independent filmmakers from different parts of India and to the spirit of indie filmmaking, the spirit of finding one way or the other to say what one wants to say through this beautiful medium called cinema that we love so much. So my name is Sashi and today my guest is Shayanthan Bose, an independent filmmaker from Kolkata. Shayanthan takes up multiple roles of the filmmaking process such as writing, directing, producing, acting, editing, as well as shooting his films. He's the founder of Elegant Drops, the production under which he makes his films. So welcome Shayanthan, how are you and how's everything?
Yes, thank you. I am privileged for this meeting. Thank you. I'm fine. I'm trying to survive in this indie session, in this indie world.
Quite an Atmanirbhar one.
Yes, right.
Yes. As let's jump straight into it. Like, as you have begun your journey as a filmmaker, you have made some short films, you have made a feature film. And yes. So why do you think that you have chosen the medium of cinema to tell your stories?
This is the most often question asked to the filmmakers, mostly the indie filmmakers, and I have this most common answer and one unique answer. Basically, I found after completing my higher secondary exam, I found that I am quite interested in writing. It was all early, but I was quite interested in writing, and some of my friend wanted to be an actor, right?
Okay.
And he took me to an audition as a just colleague to him, right? As a just a companion, nothing okay. else. And there I have found a production company. I don't know the name. Even I don't know the name of the director. Even I don't know the name of the actor or any other over there. But I just want to say one thing. They have just, they are going to treat all the newcomers, all the new actors, all the new directors, producers very badly, because they do not even give any respect to both of them.
Mm-hmm.
And that night, I was only 18, even I am also. Now I am 25, and that night they rejected me. Even I was not doing any audition, but they rejected me. That I just wanted to go home because it was 10 p.m. at night. But they rejected me that you can't go home at 10 p.m. while you are in the film media. 10 p.m. is the is like an evening or like like an afternoon. You can't go home. So that word struck me very much, and the person I do not know, I do not remember his name, and I don't know from where the spark came out, and I told him that one day I will be the filmmaker and I will achieve something. From that spark, from the next day I started making films. I didn't know anything about the film. I Google about script writing, I Google about cinematography, I took Google as the guide, as the teacher, as the guardian. And within 1 month, I decided to make my first film over the mobile phone.
How wonderful.
In 2015. Mm-hmm. And then I didn't found how to edit.
Mm-hmm.
And then again, I came to my guardian and they suggested me for Premiere Pro. Yes, you will be you may be astonished for that. No movie maker, no Windows movie maker, no mobile phone app. I started my video editing with CS6, and from there it all began. And then I started and writing, and I thought this media, I can tell some of the stories.
Yeah.
The main motto of my filmmaking is to tell the great stories with great filming language. We have lost the filming language because it's a language. No dialogues. Dialogues, musics are part of it. But the main language is the film language. The film language has all the alphabets, all the sentence construction. Even it has grammar, you know.
Of course.
Most of the indie filmmakers in my time, and showing. There are many friends of mine are doing short film music videos, and they are even don't know the 180 degree. And
okay,
they are making films and they are achieving like thousand and thousand YouTube subscribers.
Okay,
and still I didn't get why and how they can get it. So it's Indian media, right?
Yeah,
it's ultimately an Indian media.
Mm-hmm.
They choose these kind of things and they takes it for granted.
Yeah, fair enough. Yes, like, of course, like I was having this conversation only like few hours back with my brother, that I was telling him like it was very difficult making a film 50 years ago because you had someone who had the camera only was a great person because he could obtain a camera somehow and you had to buy stock and put it there. Today it's easier to make a film because you have phone camera and so many things, but everyone is making it, not just film.
Everyone is making it, yes.
YouTube not, video, not only web series. So how do you stand out? So that is the challenge, and that's there.
That's the challenge.
That's there. So Shayantan, why have you chosen the indie way? Like, why does it satisfy you?
Yes, I have chosen the indie way. The main reason is I want the theme in my own viewpoint. If the master is other, if I have a great producer who know about the filming language, who knows about the films, then it will be easier. But I didn't found no one. I didn't find no one because they just do not want to understand or to realize why the director is making it. They don't even realize that. They don't even understand that. They don't even have the sense of the filming language or any kind of film grammar and of story. So I have chosen the indie way because I have certain things which I think the commercial producers, which I say, and the sponsors may not accept. And I have my own freedom to shoot whether I want and when I want, how I want.
Yeah.
Yes, I know the budget limitation, the equipment's limitations, all the artist limitation, and even all the federation's limitations are there.
Mm-hmm.
But I have chosen the indie way. But if you want, I just want to share one thing.
Sure.
I don't know.
Go on.
I have completed my first feature film, and it has been going for 3 years. It has been going for 3 years.
Yeah. You
know? And I was doing nothing. I have no financial backup. No sponsors, nothing, just nothing. I came from negative. I started from negative.
Mm-hmm.
I was just doing some tuitions.
Okay.
And I have completed my graduation with English honors and the post graduation. And while my study time, I was doing tuitions and I saved the money from the tuitions.
Mm-hmm.
Even I was earning 10,000 per month. I was saving 8,000 from that.
Okay.
It was a huge savings.
Of course.
I have. From 10,000 saving 8,000 is a huge savings.
Yes, totally.
And from this 8,000 to 7,000, I saved this money and wanted to make the film because my script was rejected more than 14 to 15 times.
Okay.
So not one script, two or three scripts was going to reject.
Is that also the inspiration behind the shot that you made?
I don't know. Yes. It was previous time, but it was being rejected. And then I think I have to make it alone. Yes, I have to make it alone. Then I completed my film. Yes, I think it's a blessing. It's something a blessing because you will be astonished. One of my artists who came and acted for one day and went away. Okay, we waited for 1 month and then after the wait and rejected my shooting.
Oh.
And that night I felt so devastated. So what I'm doing. And again, I brought up a new artist.
Yeah, I can totally understand.
And new one and I have shoot and I have shoot more than 5 days. I am mostly 6 days with her.
Mm-hmm.
And again, she left us. So she left us, and in the middle of the shoot, we again replaced one of my artists. It was leading artist.
Mm.
Not the main protagonist, but leading artist.
Mm.
Main supporting actress. And
but
the third one came out.
Chunk of the
and
film.
The third one yeah. came out.
Mm.
Third one came out. And after that, when I was doing shooting in Kolkata, in Mirish Park area, in a very narrow alley,
mm.
some of the neighbor, he is more than 60 years old, he called me and said in Bengali, "Tumra korchota ki? Tin din dhore ei eki rasta mane he was trying to say, what are you doing? You have come in 5 months, 3 times and doing the same song line and shooting again and again and again. Only the girl is different. What are you doing, man? Again, it was the tough time. It was very tough time, but I am privileged that I have completed my film. Yes, you know, I have completed my film. It's great for me. But I have also sent it some great festivals. But it was mainly, I don't know from where the confidence came from, but I just wanted to hit the biggest one. Because you have already seen my Anuswaran, Aho. These films are already selected in some of local festivals. These local festivals are only locals. They are only earning money.
Mm.
But they are not our festivals.
Okay.
They are only earning money, even in India, you know.
Tell me more about it.
I know lot of men and women, they have rented a home, not home, they have rented a room like 4,400 or 500 square feet room.
Okay.
And they have put a laptop, a projector and a projector screen.
Mm.
And they are conducting a film festival.
Okay.
And they are also registered to Film Free Way, which is the most famous registered festival site.
Okay.
And they have put the entry fee of film festival like $50 to $60, which is
quite a lot.
Which is more than huge in Indian money.
Yes, yes, I agree.
They are conducting a fraud festival. I call it fraud, you know, because they have collected two or three friends of them and they have printed a giant banner, a giant flex. How much it will cost? 200 or 300 rupees?
Mm-hmm.
300 rupees banner. They have 5 close friends. They have put them all together in front of the banner. They captured the photo and uploaded through their Facebook website or through their uploaded through their Film Free Way account, and they are claiming the entry fees of the from the filmmakers from the different parts of our world, and they are earning a lot, and even they do not give any trophies over there. They are only supply just a certificate over the mail.
Okay.
How much a certificate cost for sending it over the mail? Zero. And the design of the certificate is so simple that even a man who doesn't even know the graphic design, who can just edit the photo for Instagram, he can also design the certificate.
Okay. Okay.
So they are conducting festivals, and most of the festivals are like that.
Okay. This is something
so I have found it.
To know. Yeah.
I found it very, very bad, very bad. So I wanted to make it bigger. I don't know. I had the confidence, and today even I surely I have the confidence about my feature film, and it's totally independent. It's totally independent.
Yeah.
I had very limited of equipments. I had just two tripods, one slider, and I made up a handmade trolley. And I had rented a drone for only 3 days, and I practiced my hand as a steadicam.
How wonderful.
A lot.
Lovely, lovely.
A lot.
Yeah.
A lot. So I have also rented the steadicam, you know. I have rented the steadicam for 3,000 per day.
Oh my God.
And after taking 2-3 shots, I realized it's so heavy.
and let begin with my hand. And I started shooting with my hand in the most crowded area of in our town, in the most crowded day, the 25th of December.
Yeah.
The 25th of December, the most crowded street of Calcutta is Park Street,
yeah,
you know.
Yeah.
And the second crowded street of Calcutta is Lake Town. And I shot over the Lake Town.
And you got the same results?
I have only three. I directed and I cinematographed. I have two artists over there. And I have one makeup artist. And I had two of my friends who was just cooperating with the crowd because it has to, because it was going to very tough. And we have shot a 4-minute scene over there. We have shoot from 7 p.m. to 11 p.m. and we got four-minute scene over there. It was great for me. It was great. And I thought that I will survive. But I have sent lot of film festivals. Mm-hmm. I have already mentioned. Yeah. Film festivals like TIFF, Geon Technically Autory, Singapore, Busan. These giant festivals. I don't know. I am telling again and again. I don't know from where the confidence came from. But I submitted to these festivals.
That's great. That's great.
But my film got rejected in many of the festivals. And the rest of the results are not released yet.
Okay.
And when my film was getting rejected, I tried to contact with many of my friends. And I was just sharing stories that my film is rejected. And my first film, this long journey, long days, it is rejected and I'm lost. Just 2 or 3 months, I felt lost, just lost. No Sandeep Maheshwari could help me. You know? No. I am lost. But again, I came to know some dark truth. Mm. The film festivals needs some agents for the selections.
Yes.
And we have to pay them. Not we have to only make the film and we have to also pay the agents for the selections.
Yeah.
And the agents are saying that they have made the connections with the festivals and these connections are not monetary or financially connections. They this is called the PR, you
know?
Yes,
yes.
This is the PR. They have connected through their PR and now they are demanding a lot of money for getting selected, for getting the selection of the filmmaker's film. And I was lost and I contacted with such people, but I had no money for the selection. And even then I tried to contact with the festival directors also.
Yeah.
You know, you have found one of the festival Geon Technically Autory Venice Days. It is the festival supported by Venice Festival. Mm-hmm. It's also held in Venice and it is the supporting festival of main Venice Festival. And I contacted over there with one of the ma'am, who was official mainly. And she guided me that 2000 films was submitted and only 10 can be selected. And they are preferring the films which have already premiered anywhere else.
Okay.
Or they have the connection, but they requested you make films and submit as much as festival as you can. But it's so dark and I am still waiting for the selection, for the official selection. I don't know is it will be happen or not, but I am waiting. I have sent it to many festivals. If it fails, then I will try in some other way. So you know my point and the how an indie filmmaker is getting lost in their way.
I totally
he is getting
agree.
Lost.
Yes,
he can make. Yes, an indie filmmaker can make film. He can write it. He can write in his own. He can direct. He can cinematograph. He can color. He can sound. He can do everything. But while publishing, today all the theaters are closed.
Yes,
only OTTs has survived. And in, I think every Indian filmmaker's dream about festivals.
Definitely.
Not OTT.
Yes.
I assure you, if I know these dark truths of film festivals 3 years earlier, then I may not have this guts for making a 2 hours long film. It's 2 hours 11 minutes long.
Okay.
I didn't have the guts. If I knew it earlier.
But why should that bother you? But it's your expression that you want to put out. You have a story to tell. You want to make it. If it doesn't click, you would make a one more and try again. Yeah. I understand your point. You may tell me.
From where the monetary money will come from? Because money is also need for survival. We can't take it for granted. We must need food at least 3 times a day.
Of course.
We must need to pay our mobile phone bill, our electric bill, our water bill, our internet bill, our college fees. It's all thing. But even I don't know how to approach the OTTs, Netflix, Amazon's, Z5 or Sony Leaves. I am trying to connect with OTTs, but there is also the connection of the majors. Who have the connection of majority, who have the more connections, more reference, they will get chance first.
Of course.
The indie will be backward.
I think things will change, and I think it's true for everyone and every artist working in any art form. Like, gradually you will have to make your way. I completely get that without any backing from a studio or a production house or someone who has contacts, it is difficult, because it is not that cinema was born like 2 years back and now we are the first people to be making films. Then anything we make will become famous. But it is now a little, like, of course it's a young medium, but it is like more than 100 years old now, and so many people make it. So a lot of the films go unnoticed also, like even when it comes to Academy Awards, so many countries submit their films, and not every film is being watched when it comes to selecting the top nominations. It's not that they have watched all the films. It is not definitely a game of merit. So a lot of other factors are involved. But what can you do? You want to express, you would, but also money is a factor, and yeah, we have to find our own ways and just keep our hopes alive, looking at the masters who have done it over the years, and definitely we will all find our own ways. So
we have to keep the patience.
Definitely. And kudos to you for all that you have done and the film that you have made, and all your shooting stories have been so inspiring. So I want to talk about, like, how's the approach towards indie filmmaking among Kolkata public or your family, friends, relatives? How do they look at this thing, this choice of yours that you've made?
Yes, it's a very good question. First of all, they don't even know what is indie, man. because we are saving time by saying indie, not saying independent. Right?
Yes.
We are saving time and who on the independent film, I think most of the men, in terms of family, friends or the neighbors, most of the men do not respect this thing, because they do not see the glamour. They do not see the fame.
They do not see
even
money.
They don't can see the money.
Yeah.
So how can they respect it? People respect these kinds of things, the glamour, the talent, the money. How will be the talent exposed without glamour, without fame?
Of course.
If a painter paints a great picture and publishes nowhere, if only his parents have seen the painting, who will appreciate him? Who will praise his art form? No one, right? Because he is not gaining any fame not gaining any money. And I hope you will agree with me. Today, a very word is so popular called in our side. It's so Facebook celebrity.
Yes.
Yes, it's a Facebook celebrity. That means who publishes every day, who gets more than 500 likes and comments,
mm-hmm.
and people watch them again and again.
Social media influencer. Yeah.
Yes, social media influencer. People watch them again and again. And they found, okay, মানে তারা বাংলায় আর কি বলে যে সিনেমা তো করছো কিন্তু হবে টা কি এর পরে
টোটালি
মানে ইউ ইউ আর ডুইং ইট বাট হোয়াট উইল বি দ্য নেক্সট মানে এরকম একটা বিষয় যে মানে আলটিমেট দে ডু নট সি ইট অ্যাজ এ প্রফেশন বিকজ দ্য মানি ইজ নট কামিং অ্যাট লিস্ট আই থিঙ্ক ইভেন ইফ four or five lakhs can come in a year, an indie filmmaker can survive. I hope. I am not saying a lot much. Even a government job employee in India earn 10 lakhs in a year, near about. Who drives the train in railway jobs or in post office jobs,
yes.
the famous government jobs. And I can say, if I earn 5 to 6 lakhs in a year, I can survive with indie filmmaking. At least I will have again my family. I am not married yet, but one day she will come, and my parents, and I have to give them that survival. So after I survive, then I will carry on my art form, na?
I understand. I agree. Of course,
it's very difficult.
Yes.
They are not respected. They don't respect this indie film.
Yeah, and fair enough for them to not respect it. Like, of course,
you know, nothing is coming from that. No money, no fame, no glamour.
And what would you do with your internal satisfaction? Is how they look at it.
Yes, yes. Yeah. No one can see internal satisfaction, and even no one can see the internal frustration and internal failure. No one can see.
Yeah, totally. I completely agree. Like, actually, I was reading this. Someone had shared it on Facebook yesterday. Then I also shared it back. That Satyajit Ray, after when Apurajito didn't work out commercially at the box office, he had written this in a letter somewhere that I might have to return back to advertising if my next film also doesn't earn money. But he didn't, right? He survived. He made films. And these are the stories that keep us alive.
But these are the stories. But you know, the father of Satyajit Ray was Sukumar Ray.
Yes.
The grandfather of Satyajit Ray was Upendra Kishan Ray. Yeah. So it's Satyajit Ray, and I'm not Satyajit Ray because my father is no one, and my grandfather is no one. Even all the things of Satyajit Ray are. Critically, they have collected all the things together. Critically, they have collected all the things together, and they made a memory with all of them. But the other filmmakers of that contemporary time, like Hrithik Ghatak or Mrinal Sen, nothing is formed. Even you know, one of my close friend, he was a friend of Mrinal Sen's son. After the death of Mrinal Sen, his son was so lost that where he should publish or where he should collect all his father's belongings. But he found no one to keep or wishes to keep all the Mrinal Sen's belongings, because as Mrinal Sen is not the son of Sukumar Ray or no any other great family. So Satyajit Ray has a great family and great background. Not one ancestor, two ancestor background. Grandfather, father. So it has helped.
It does.
The first film of Satyajit Ray, Pathir Pachali, it was great. It was great.
But it got a lot of support from the government.
Yes, after the completion of the film, the West Bengal government produced the film. And after completion of my film, what I have get? Nothing. Mm. I can, yes, I know my film is not great like Pather Pachani. But I can assure you the treatment of my film and how the approach I have applied and what was the resources I had before the making of the film, it was so much different. I can assure you it's very, the budget of my film is, I am not saying the proper budget, but it's below 5 lakh.
Okay, that's commendable actually. You've made a feature with below 5 lakhs and it's inspiring.
It's 2 hour long, 2 hour 11 minutes, total 131 minutes feature film. And totally designed sound, no boom, all are dubbed, Foley sound, ambient sound, all original sounds. No, original sound means all are studio sounds.
Okay.
And even I have collected the original sounds. And they are all mixed up in a sound table. And I have edited the film in my own machine, which has i5 processor of 3rd gen.
Okay.
Today, people are buying laptops with i5 10th gen. And I have the PC of i5 3rd gen. Even I don't have an SSD hard disk.
I think
with
that
this
is,
machine.
That is the story. And that's inspiring. I totally think this is the story. This is your story, which will serve as an inspiration because it's inspiring me.
But it will definitely inspire others if it comes to public. It is bounded over the phone and over my friends. No one knows this story.
Yeah, that.
How they will know if my film successes? Then I can tell my story. If a man is failure, no one wants.
We only talk about success stories. We don't talk about the people who tried hard. We usually don't talk. And I think that's a problem. Like, even
yes,
I'm
yes.
just focusing on success stories and reading about people who...
Yes, me too. It's the human psychology. Today, when Sushant Singh Rajput and Manoj Bajpayee, these great men, or Pankaj Tripathi, we hear their stories, their interviews, lot of time and gets inspired. But you also know many of the men who tried to be Sushant or Manoj or Pankaj Tripathi, but they have failed. But they had the story maybe more interesting than those, than Sushant, than Manoj. But it's not so popular and it's not so, it's very unknown because they have failed. People just want to know the successful stories, the stories from the successful man. Even a failure man also have done the great approaches, all the great tries.
Sometimes might have made it better than the people who have had success, and that's very evident. That always happens, I think.
It always happens. It's very difficult. Very difficult. I don't know.
But I still think you are doing a great job, and I think the approach should be to be happy in life, right? Like, this is what I think at the end of everything. Like, what's important? It's my happiness.
Yes,
it's
yes,
my physical,
yes, my happiness
and spiritual well-being that I ultimately look up to in this in this life that I have been blessed with. If I consider a life a blessing or a gift, then it's me taking care of myself. And forget all these film festivals or whatever awards. Forget all that. You made a film within 5 lakhs, a 2 hour film. It's inspiring me so much. So if one can figure out a revenue,
maybe this is the first time in indie filmmaking in India. Maybe in 5 lakhs too long, 2 hour film. And you know, I had a crew of only 3 members. Me, one of my friend who had the camera basically. He had the camera and I requested his father to produce it, not with money, with his camera. Only the camera. You give me the camera and the angry father, yes, I loved uncle very much. He told me, okay, take the camera and take my son also in YouTube. Okay. So my friend and his camera was there. It was the thing. And one of my my girlfriend was doing art direction. Mm-hmm. And he was making the costumes, not stretching, and he was collecting the costumes Saul. I know a friend who knows who know others.
Yeah, that's the very spirit of ending.
Yes, yes.
Doing jugar. Yes. Yeah.
Jugar. Yes, jugar is the very. Even I have done. I never did any kind of VFX or animation works, and suddenly. Starting the editing work, I think that I must try a special opening credit, and I made a plan of opening credit, and I consulted with a lot of my friends, but no one could suggest anything. Then again, I came to my guardian Google, and I have made in my computer an animation of erasing the landscape, and. It will be drawn landscape and it will be erased, and then the name will be came up, the opening credit.
Yeah.
And I have done the animation in my machine After Effects. In this machine, most of the men says, we don't have a machine, we don't have a great PC. How can we manage? But I have only 27,000 CPU 3 years back. And I was doing Premiere Pro, After Effects, DaVinci Resolve as color in this PC. So you can't disrespect this PC or
totally.
Totally.
And
we have to do the best whatever I have.
Of course.
I must respect my resource. If
Absolutely.
I say again and again, I have this, I don't have these, I don't have these, I don't have any connection, I don't have anything, I don't have money, then you will be ended up with a not.
See.
And
yeah.
If, yes.
See, you are already
there
with that positive attitude, and I think that is the most important thing.
I am just trying to survive. Yes. I don't skip from this filmmaking. I am trying to survive. I am trying to contact with a lot of men. So I am just going to be a commercial, not an indie. Because if I contact with a lot of commercial men, commercial producers, commercial actors,
yes.
or commercial men, crew, then it will not be indie. But I must collect those connections, because these connections will help me in my future.
Okay.
Because with this connection, I can't earn anything.
So, you mean to say
that
you want to participate in the mainstream filmmaking process or films which make more money?
Yes, yes. More money, not more money. I just want to survive. I want to tell stories. But some are the sponsors or producers are telling that they are giving me 5 lakhs or 4 lakhs or 3 lakhs. And again, I am supplying 4 or 5 lakhs and I am collecting 20 to 30.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Then I can, and they are, they have the all the trust with me, and I am making the film, and it is also indie film. And if those men assure me that I need those men who had the connection of film festivals or the OTT service.
Mm-hmm.
If those men can assure me that, okay, you make an indie film, but you will be survived with your money.
Mm.
And if a 30 lakhs film can earn 50 lakhs, I don't want the maximum revenue, but I just want my remunerations as a director, as a writer, as an editor, or as a producer. If as a producer I am investing 4 lakhs, I just want 6 lakhs. I don't want 8 lakhs.
Mm-hmm. Fair enough.
So if someone can assure me that if I can, they can put my film to a OTT, not indie OTT. Now in Kolkata there are 2 or 3 indie OTT channels. They are saying this is indie OTT, right? how the indie filmmaking is gone, is there is no soil under their feet, and they are creating indie OTTs. How they will survive? So if someone can assure me that I will put your film in OTTs, or if at least, see, at least I do not want that much money, I do not want that much fame, at least I want that much respect from the press, at least from the festivals. They can honor or they can judge my film with no politics, with no special reference. This is the most, the lacking thing. You know, this is the mostly lacking.
Mm-hmm.
So if anyone can assure me that it will come to OTT or it will can gain some festival selection, I'm not telling for awards, selection, then okay, I'm ready for again producing or directing an indie film.
Mm.
Even I don't have my personal camera, how will I shoot?
I'm sure you will find such people and you will connect to them.
My words are not so much interesting or not so much enchanting, because no one knows my name, even very few people have seen my works. So you know, this is very this may be a ridiculous thing what I am talking
no,
about.
No, of course not. Of course not. This is the story I was looking for, and this, you're speaking right from your heart, and this is what I think everyone will connect to. So let us talk a little bit about your work. So I've seen your films, and I think the use of music is very prominent in your films. There are actors who sing also in your your characters are singing in your films.
Yes.
So personally, I don't very quite relate to it, but I want to understand your perspective when you make a film in that way. How does it come?
Yes,
why
yes,
are you
yes.
so connected to music? And are you also
I'm so
influenced
connected.
By Vin Carter?
No, I am mainly, I don't know. I am mainly inspired from Indian cinema and Indian culture. Indian culture.
Yes.
The music is so much rooted to our society and culture.
Of course.
Yes. While the people can say jazz or pop or rock, these are the mediums of music. The jazz music has spread all over the world. The rock music has spread all over the world. The pop has spread same, but some say the Western music. The Western music means the European music, mainly the European music, right? All European
music
means,
so please educate me.
Okay, okay. Yeah, the Western music means, mostly Western music means the European music.
Mm-hmm.
The European music means all the continents of the Europe.
Mm-hmm.
Not only specific countries, all the continents. But when we say in between of them, we say Indian music, it's a country, it's not a continent.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a country and we are saying Indian music. So we can relate the how much the Indian music is reached. And next, come to the point. Music inspires me most.
Mm.
I see, I watch, I hear lot of works with music. Even Satyajit Ray films, even the great filmmakers of India like Maniratna. Maniratna is one of my favorites.
Yes.
Like Ashutosh Gwarikar, who made films like Lagaan, it is also enriched with music, because music can create such a sense of emotion,
yes,
can create such a sensation in people's mind. It's so touching because music has not only music has also the lyrics and the music.
Mm.
And it creates a great emotional value to man. So when I think, and I have the second approach, I just want to mention, when I made Anuswaran,
yes.
And even I have made Aho, the both of my protagonists are singing songs.
Yes.
And it's like they are casual.
Mm-hmm.
In every family of India, in every house, and in every festival, we play music, right?
Of course.
Yes, we play music, and in sometimes even it is not festival. In early morning, our parents or our grandfathers or our elders places the old musics for their relaxation, for their peace of mind, for their calmness. Mm. So music is a place where we can flow something. Yes. We can, in Parasite.
Yes.
In Parasite, it's like jack. That not my language. It's happening. There is a jerk. Oh, what has happened? Whoa. Mm-hmm. So it's coming so much. Wow. It's like jumping from a hill, jumping from a mountain. It's like scuba diving. But if I use music, it's like a fountain. It's like a river, which doesn't create so much wow, so much sound, but it flows. It flows through our heart. It flows through our mind. So if we hear the sound, if we hear the lyrics, it's a peace of mind. It's not my thing. It's Indian culture. It's
totally.
It's going.
Mm-hmm.
In every films. From that thing, I just want to mention this thing. In my feature films, you will be just blown away that there are, each 2 hour, 11 minutes feature film, there are six songs.
How wonderful.
The six songs and the timings of the very small. 2 minutes, 1 minute, 1 minute 30 seconds. These are the timings. Right. And you know how I have used the music? In commercial films, mostly we think, most of the people think in commercial films, there will be dance and there will be songs. And in art film, there will be no dance, no music, no songs. Right. There will be silence, there will be no dialogue, there will be, everything will be slow. The camera will be back trolling very slowly, not very fast.
Yeah.
It's so much, I think this is not, this is so much popularized.
Yeah.
Stereotypes, it's the stereotypes. But I have made this feature film like a challenge to all the commercial directors.
Hmm.
I know no one will accept my challenge because I am done. None to them.
It's okay, but you're making a point, you're proving your point. Tell me about
basically it. I am trying to prove my point that I am just explaining one of my scene.
Sure.
Right? In a scene, my two protagonists are telling about the sunset.
Mm.
Right? The girl is telling his friend or his lover that why you are angry.
Mm.
Right? Why you are angry? And then you can hear me,
yes.
Right? Yes. You know, why you are angry?
Yes.
And the lover says, please don't call me by my name.
Mm.
Please call me in your name, by the name of yours.
Mm-hmm.
And then woman says that I am not poetic like you. These are the dialogues, mainly the subtitle dialogues.
Mm.
These are mainly the subtitle dialogues.
Yes, yes.
Okay.
I know the magic
that,
of it is in the language.
In my own language, Bangla.
Yeah.
Exactly, in Bengali.
Yes.
And then the male protagonist, named as Somudro, he says that we have days and night, right? And days are longer and nights are smaller. People think like that because people are awakened throughout the day and they are slept throughout the night, right? Most of the people.
Yes.
I'm talking about most of the people. So and they do not see the night. They can't see the darkness. And the darkness has no limitation. If I switch off the light of my room, it's not a dialogue I am explaining
yes,
to you. If I switch off the light of my room, then I don't know where the wall of my room is ending. I really don't know.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
I don't know so the light, if I switch on the light, then I will know that here is the wall, here is the door, here is the window. So I will have the limitation.
Yes.
But the darkness makes us a way of going to an unlimited land. So then, after this conversation, a song starts. If it is the time to set the sun, then it's okay. Let it be. বাংলায় একটা পুরনো গান আছে উত্তম কুমারের, সূর্য ডোবার পালা আসে যদি আসুক বেশ তো, ঠিক আছে? আই হ্যাভ পুট দ্য ওল্ড বেঙ্গলি সংস, নট দ্য নিউ সংস,
দ্য উত্তম কুমার,
ইয়েস ইয়েস ইয়েস,
ইয়া,
উত্তম কুমার, দ্য উত্তম কুমার সংস, দ্য নেম, দ্য লিরিক্স অফ দ্য সং ইজ লাইক, ইফ ইটস দ্য টাইম টু সেট দ্য সান, লেট ইট বি, ডু নট হোল্ড ইট, সো ইউ ক্যান রিলেট. The dialogues and the lyrics.
How beautiful.
How yeah. they are related.
Mm-hmm.
How they are related. And the main theme of the film is the two protagonists who are playing the role, and when the songs are playing, there are other two.
Mm.
Mainly this is the magic of both protagonists.
Mm.
They are not same men or women who are acting. They are different men and women. But they are representing them. They are representing their soul in music. So I have two parallel narratives in my film. One narrative is based on dialogue and one narrative is based on music.
Lovely.
But the dialogue narrative is like long and the music narrative is very small, like 10 to 12 minutes.
So every time when there is a song, there are other two people who are representing the song, like representing the characters.
Yes,
who are
yes, yes.
The dialogue exactly. otherwise.
Yes,
okay,
yes.
That's a fantastic thought process. Yeah,
they are representing the song, and the others two are representing the dialogue.
So their souls
and
come
mainly
alive like that.
Thus, yes, we see in the whole film that no one are they are in love, but they are not so much attached.
Hmm.
Like they are spending time in a room, in a alone, but they are not holding their hands.
Mm-hmm.
And they're not holding.
But don't realistically to the point that like people are
yes, yes, yes.
know it now. So then the fun of watching the film would be gone. Yes.
I do not want to reveal the story,
yes.
but this is the
yes,
thing.
Yes.
Like they are not attached, but in the song, they are all they have gained their wings.
Mm.
It's like they have gained their wings. So this is the approach I have made. So I am using commercial songs,
mm-hmm.
like commercially. It's totally. The songs are totally made commercial.
Mm.
The totally magical treatment, drone shots, magical colors,
yeah.
the continuously costume changing. So all
yes.
the old, and the matching costume. The old 90s Bengali song, and the hero is wearing a pink shirt and the heroine is wearing a pink sari. The costumes are also like same. So I am trying to prove that I am investing the same costume and the same idea with my song and the lyrics, but they are representing another viewpoint. We can use the song, but use logical.
Very true.
Use,
very true.
Just maintain the film language. We can't use I is your friend. I have to use I am your friend. We can't use is. In spite of am.
Yeah, lovely
right?
analogy.
So the am must come after I. Is cannot come, never can come.
Hmm.
So while those men, if Shah Rukh Khan looks at Kajol at a rail station and then na jaane mere dil ko kya ho gaya and gone to the long long film. It's not logical. It's
not
like,
logical, but it's its own world of magic which is created.
It's magic.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, it's magic. That's why this is the magic.
But you have to maintain the language of magic throughout the film. That is
yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Wonderful.
And it's the magic of only Indian films.
Totally. Like it's our own genre, the masala film genre that we have created and we have given it to the world. I think no one else can do it like the way we do it.
So I do not want to lift the way and lift my culture and I do not want to skip my culture and the heritage. I want to establish the culture and heritage in a new style, in a new type, in a new way. I'm just trying to tell the stories. So this is my all approach to song.
That's wonderful, and it's inspiring that you've created your own sort of language, retaining the Indian mainstream language as well as the indie scene, which has created with
and the
stories.
Most of the people say the artistic language, the art film.
Yeah. So now I actually want to come to this section where I would like to know, now we in India at least we have two styles of filmmaking: the masala filmmaking, which has all the elements of a typical Hindi film, Bollywood film, and then when it comes to art house cinema, we always see we talked about the stereotypes of art house cinema, it has to starve you, it has to bore you, or there will be no songs, at least not a studio record. There are songs, of course, you get me what I'm trying to say, right? So
yes. There must be songs, but without any instrument playing background.
Sometimes there are instruments playing background also, but those are theme songs which depict a certain state of mind or certain.
Yes, you get me right.
It can't be someone who would lip sync the song. When I told you,
it's just depicting the situation.
Yes, totally. When I told you, I don't quite relate to the way you put songs in your film. So I'm very inclined towards the new realism kind of cinema, which is being made in India.
Yes.
So, but I want to know this from you now. Now that you have mixed both of them and you are trying to create a language of your own. And it actually reminds me of Ritwik Ghatak movies, because he never left singing. He used to put songs in his movies where people used to sing it lip sync it. So... And now there are two languages of filmmaking in India. And so what do you think should be the future of the language of Indian cinema? Now, one group is making mainstream, one group is making art house. And how one is the Indian method, which usually is not...
the masala film.
Yeah, masala film, which usually cannot be... is not identified as a matured genre, I would say. The products which come out of the masala genre are not as matured or at par with a wonderful, very remarkable international film. But
yes,
again, what we make art house, it's not a style that has come from India. It's if you see a French movie and you make an Indian story with
an Iranian movie.
Yeah, Iranian movie or French movie. Those film styles have come out of that land because of their own. Those are a product of their own history, politics, culture, geography also. So,
yes.
What do you think? What are your views on what should be Indian cinema's language?
You have mentioned a good point that the cultures, the history of geography of another world or another continent has come to India. You maybe agree with me that Indian directors or Indian films has a great probability to make things, not only film, make paintings, make songs, or make films inspired by from other things. It's very popular to India, right? Most of the greatest men are being inspired.
Yes.
You know what I'm trying to say? It's not like copy. It's inspired. So, okay. The future of Indian cinema mainly depends on how the upcoming Indian directors are treating those things. Are they treating all those old things which have already spent or done in French or in US or in Canada, and they want to bring all those things to India, in 10 years back all the Bengali directors was seeing the South Indian films and they were remaking these films in Kolkata, and it was box office hit. So who made this film hit? The directors and the audience. The future of India mainly depends on how the audience reacts to the directors. I just do not blame the audience. It's also the
it's also the chance and it's also the duty of the director to give them the opportunity of new film. As the time is going, as the technology is changing, as everything is evolving, the film must be evolved with time. Right? If an art film has its own language, own Indian language, then it is right. Every director must make a film with such great stories, which may have never been told. These stories must be told. Like, I just want to say, I was returning from Sialdah, and I saw some slums, and the slums and the people who lived in the slums, they were gossiping, they were playing beside the train, and they don't even have any dare of death. They are very freely. So if I make a film of a slum men or a slum family about their people and a class distinction of the the iPhone user.
Yes.
And if the story contemplates with those things and make a great art house film, then it's good. You must serve your culture, your time, your society, and you must not forget your heritage, your belongings. So the future depends on the directors
and the audience
who are making it, and the audiences, and mostly the future depends on the producers who are investing.
Totally. That's a lovely point you made, because we are all like getting inclined towards the Western approach of filmmaking. Like, even my sensibilities are improving with this discussion, and it's a lovely, like, it's lovely that you have that clarity. And I think there are very few people who are brave enough to take this decision that you want to retain the Indian elements of filmmaking as well as tell stories with your reality, with the honesty and truth. And it takes a lot of courage, because...
Yes, we could not escape with this reality, because we live in this reality, we die in this reality. How we can escape from this reality?
Very true.
I need the great directors must have the great power of observations.
Absolutely.
And the great power of remember all of those things which they are seeing around them every day, every time. What the rickshaw man is telling to his friends. Like, I suppose I am sharing my observation, and it will keep in my mind and my head.
Sure.
I was going on an auto, and suddenly the man who was driving his auto, he told one of his friend, of a rickshaw man in Bengali, that to chaka to break dance koche to chaka to break dance koche to passenger to pore jabe. So your wheel of the rickshaw is break dancing and your passenger will fall down soon. And then, you know what the rickshaw puller replied? The rickshaw puller replied, ja hoy bhalo jonno hoy. What happens, it happens for good. So I just want to see the expression of the passenger of the rickshaw puller that point of time. What was the passenger? It must be the expression of that Pakistan fan in Cricket World Cup. It must be the expression. And if a director creates this scene in film, it's a no one can say this is a copy. Is it a copy?
No, it's your truth.
If I create this scene, it's the truth. And if I make this scene properly with proper casts, with proper shots and proper editing, then it can create the original Indian film.
Totally.
So you must have that observation, and you have to put that observation in the film language, in the film grammar.
Perfect. That's lovely. And
yes.
Yeah, this is a really good discussion I'm having. And I want to talk about your work as an actor, because I think you are a fabulous actor, like in your film Anusharan, where the scene where you talk to your wife and during the Durga Puja, the background where Durga Puja, the immersion is happening. And so tell me the process when you act in front of your camera and you're directing yourself.
It's very difficult.
Yes, how do you do
it? It's very difficult. I don't know how I have done it. I just did it. Basically, I tried. I just didn't look over the mirror, right? While acting, I just tried to focus in my co-actor's eyes. Mm. If I am saying dialogues in front of his face, and if I am saying any kind of dialogues, then I just forget where the camera is.
Wow, that's
I just pick up any props like a pen stand. Mm. I focus my eye on a pen stand. I think this is the enemy of my life. Mm. And I, if I have to act angrily, then I just react to the pen stand. Mm. And if I have to love, then I just react to the pen stand. I focus on the props. And mainly sometimes after the cut, I don't say that, you know, when I am acting, I don't say the action and I don't can say the cut. So when I am prepared, then I give the total freedom to my cinematographer. Mm. I have set the frame, right? I set the frame and then I go to the position. And then I makes lot of takes. I know the first 2, 3, or 5 takes will be so bad because my mind will be focused on the camera. And after 5 to 7 or 8 takes, I will be habituated with my acting. I will forget my camera. Then the acting will automatically come up.
Wonderful, wonderful. And I'm like, it's fabulous. Like your performances are fabulous. I love them. And also, like, tell me one thing. This is a fun question. Like, do other actors feel insecure when their director is such a good-looking actor, good-looking guy?
No, that's I feel my other sector are more not Anuswaran, but in my even in my feature film, I have also acted in the song sequences.
Yes, I've seen the trailer. Yes,
and then I just give them when I complete my shot, I just ask my co-actor, "Shob thik ache to?" Just no, everything is fine, right? So when I ask them everything is fine, they feel okay. So why my director is asking that? Is he right or wrong? So okay, I am doing totally fine. So I just give them their freedom. You just act as your wish. You don't have to worry who is in front of you. Your director, your producer, or whoever you have. You just act yours. That's why I just come closer to them and takes my hands closer and say, it's fine, right? Amar kono bhul hole ektu bolo. Please mention if I make any wrong, because I have also the in Bengali the ojuhat, right? The excuse. Then you know, my concentration was all about the camera. I could not focus in my acting, so I will make lot of wrong things. Please give a lot, and I take I make mistakes, many take. I used to take many takes, so sometimes they are and I what I say that, you know, I am feeling very bad and you have acted very well, so I am, please give me a chance to please give me a chance to develop myself in my acting. So they are very much friendly. Okay, do it more, do it again. So it helps.
Yeah,
just be with them. Never feel you are the director or you are the producer of the film. You are just the maker of the film.
Yeah,
you are just friend, you are just a coordinator, you are a team.
Totally.
That's
totally
it.
And it's such a wonderful process through which you learn so many things, and I'm sure it's a lot of fun when you're in the process.
Yes,
you forget about everything.
Yes, it's lots of Yes, it's lots of fun because last 2 days, I just say it's a very personal thing, but last 2 days I have joined in a job, right? It's not a corporate job, it's a media house job where I have to make short videos and edits for Facebook videos.
Okay.
And they will give very short amount of salary. It's like 9 or 10,000 in a month.
Okay.
Right. And I will make I'll arrange my tuition so it will
suffice.
Can bring me I will survive at least. But I have completed 2 days of my office. But I think if I invest my 5,000 of a month totally, and when I shoot it, then that's the satisfaction. Yes, I also regret when I came back and I see my wallet is empty. I don't have money to buy cigarette and I feel so devastated. But at the point of time, why I am shooting, while I am shooting, the magical frame of my mind, the magical frame of my storyboard, it's the ultimate satisfaction. With satisfaction is fabulous. It cannot be exchanged. It's everything to me. I homework with storyboards a lot. I have done 3 or 4 updates in my storyboards, in my feature films. 4 drafts. The 4 drafts of storyboarding. And I paint very bad. I cannot draw anything. But after 4 drafts, you know, the magic of shots will come up. Because the labor, the hard work is there. This is the thing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. That's it.
Yeah, I understand. So
yes. I don't know. What's your time? I just want to take something point of how you are doing with indie films. I don't know anything about you, many things about you, but I just know some things. If you want to say about you, that what you do with your indie films and what your job with the films, and you direct, you make films.
No, actually, I have just started, like, only at the beginning, not even at the beginning of my career. I'm just writing something. I'm writing a screenplay and I hope to make it in the near future. So
okay.
I haven't made anything. So that this is one of the reasons why I'm doing this podcast, that it's a good way to connect with people, hear their stories and be inspired all the time. Otherwise, I work as a writer in a Bombay-based media house. So that's a job that I do.
Great.
And gradually I'm trying to make my own thing. But it's so inspiring.
I am very much interested. My English is very bad. Please pardon
me.
Right?
Language is not.
I speak in Bengali all the time. I do not have.
I wish my English is very bad.
I
wish we could speak in Bangla itself. Only because of the audience that this podcast is supposed to reach out to. That's the reason why restrict you to.
I just wanted to connect with one of them, one of the cinematographer in Bombay who shot Lutera.
Okay.
Mr. Mahendra Shetty. I just wanted to connect with him. I messaged him over Facebook and he replied, but after some time he became busy and the conversation was stopped over there. So I am very much interested to work with this man. Maybe first of all, if I could assist him in his cinematography work, because I have a lot of interest in cinematography also, and so if I can assist him in cinematography, it will be a great opportunity for me. But mainly I do not have any connection in Kolkata, so how I can arrange connection in Bombay, it's a very hard thing. And it how I will go Bombay without any connection, and even I have no connection, and I must have to survive in just at least 1 month to make connections, right?
Yes.
Yeah, I just want to do work with assistant cinematographer or as a unit assistant or as a fourth or fifth AD in a production. But for that I also need a connection, and no one will give me any job over there.
Yes.
Even my own state, my own city is not giving me anything. And how Bombay will react?
I don't think you should think like that, because you never know. Maybe Bombay will react to you better. You never know. But yes, yes, of course, you need to. It is.
I need to know some of men of Mumbai who are working with.
I think it's a good way to reach out to people over social media. We have that weapon today, and it's a good way to reach out to people, mail them, or it will work out. I think like gradually it does work out, and
yes, I am trying.
And
yes,
we can just put it out to the universe that. अगर
yes, yes.
दिल से कोशिश करो तो पूरी कायनात लग जाती है एंड आई थिंक आई एम श्योर इट्स गोइंग टू हैपन सो वी हैव ऑलमोस्ट कम टू द एंड एंड
यस
डू यू हैव एनीथिंग दैट यू वांट टू से दैट माइट हैव गॉटन मिस्ड आउट आई माइट हैव
नो दैट्स नॉट मच आई जस्ट वांट टू से गॉड इज ग्रेट यार आई मैन ऑलवेज सेज गॉड इज ग्रेट बट I think I also agree with him that God is great and we must have patience in our work and in our art and in our hard work. I believe someday it will return. The hard work will return.
Of course.
At the end of the day, evil cannot win every time.
Mm.
You know, at the end of the war of Mahabharata, Kurukshetra war, yes, all the Pancho Pandu, all the Pancho five Pandavas won the battle, but yes. They have lost everything.
Yes.
They have lost their children, they have lost their families, they have lost their loves, they have lost everything. They have only conquered the throne.
Yes, even Krishna had to pay for what he did.
Yes, yes. We are just waiting for that magic.
Of course.
Maybe the success of winning the throne is the success is establishing ourselves as a filmmaker. I do not want to say as a director or producer. I just want to say as a filmmaker. Yeah. We just want to survive as a filmmaker, and this hard time will go away.
Of course.
I just believe this.
Mm.
Because there is a blessing. Yes, hard time will come, but one day this hard time, after 2 years or 5 years, after 10 years, I am trying to survive being myself last 6 years, but I have not done anything that much. Still, I have that much courage to make my film.
Mm. Yes, I think that's
I still
enough.
Believe.
Yeah.
This positive approach. Ultimate, we have all the Sandeep Maheshwari within us. We must dug it out.
Of course.
We must dug it out. All Sandeep Maheshwari and all the Steve Jobs are within
us.
Of course. The man or the woman who are able to dug them up, they are successful.
Totally. So, thank you so much, Shantan. And it was lovely talking to you. You spoke your heart out totally. And... I'm sure you will continue to work the way you are and keep inspiring yourself as well as people around you. And the perspective about the language of filmmaking, which you shared with me today, it's extremely inspiring and something very brief when it comes to filmmakers I usually talk to. So thank you for participating.
Thank you.
All the best.
Yes.
Rekla. And take care.
All good. Thank you.